promises. I promise that I will love you and care for you to the fullest reach both of it. I take you with all my your strengths and weaknesses. As I offer you myself with all my strengths and weaknesses. I'll help you if you need help and to help you. I choose you as the person whom I wish to spend the rest of my life.
Benjamin, I take you as my lovely wedded husband. Before these witnesses, I promise I'll love you and I'll care for you as long as we both shall live. I take you with all your strengths and weaknesses, as I offer you myself with all my strengths and weaknesses. I'll turn to you if I need help, and I'll help you if you need help. I choose you as a person with whom I want to spend my life.
Vaše rozhodnutí vstoupit do manželství je lidsky krásné, společensky prospěšné, pro vás závazné a závažné a mělo by být neměnné. Žijte proto spolu tak, abyste byli pro ostatní báječným příkladem.
Dear Petra and Benjamin, the decision to marry is beautiful and it's also socially beneficial. For you, it is a lasting commitment. So, live your lives together in such a way that others may also wish to have your happiness.
Vážení snoubenci, nyní před vámi stojím jako zástupkyně občanů tohoto města, abych vašemu rozhodnutí dala právní formu souhlasný, veřejný, a obou stranů projevem vaší vůle.
Dear Petra and Benjamin, I'm standing today as a representative of Český Krumlov and its residents, and in compliance with your wish to get married publicly, it is my privilege and honor to give you this zákonem.
Který při tomto obřadu zastupuji, táži se vás, vážený pane ženichu, Benjamin Francis Charles Hansen, zda vstupujete dobrovolně do manželství se zde přítomnou nevěstou, slečnou Petrou Vojtěchovou.
Before the law I represent here, may I ask you, Benjamin Hansen, do you take Petra Vojtěchová to be your wedded wife?
Ano.
A nyní se táži vás, vážená nevěsto, slečno Petro Vojtěchová, zastupujete dobrovolně do manželství se zde přítomným panem Benjamin Francis Charles Hansen.
May I ask you, Petra Vojtěchová, do you take Benjamin Hansen to be your wedded husband?
Ano.
Yes, I do.
Děkuji vám. A nyní vás oba prosím, abyste si vyměnili snubní prstínky a dali se první manželské oblíbení.
And now it's time to exchange rings.
Thank you.
one is water, I don't know which. The person that gets the water will be the sensible one, and the person that gets the sliver it will be the fun one. Petra.
Na zdraví.
Oh.
having everyone here, people who are really close to our hearts, has meant so much to us. To celebrate our marriage together has meant so much. And we certainly appreciate it. It hasn't been the easiest wedding for everyone to come to. So we just hope you have a fantastic time. And yeah, celebrate the day with us. In particular, we have to give a lot of thanks to our parents. Mum and Dad in particular, you've been absolutely fantastic. I mean, from the absolute onset, from the surprise engagement party all the way through to just everything just sorting us out. She's driving champagne across Europe. thankfully not taking around the Nürburgring. You've made this day even special, and as I'm sure hopefully you'll all agree, this has been the wedding of our dreams. Dad and Louise, we're going to have two absolutely amazing honeymoons, which wouldn't be possible without you. And without your help, and maybe have a trip to the lifetime, which we'll remember forever, so thank you. Thomas, that's Susanna. So at this point, I have to kind of stop going and probably go on to it. It's a translation. I'm going to try and battle through some Czech.
Thank you.
thinking the same thing, and we always react to that because we always know what each other are thinking. Petra, you're my lover, you're my soulmate, and most importantly, my best friend. And whatever happens in the future during the rest of our lives together, it's going to be absolutely great and beneficial. So, ladies and gentlemen, if you raise your glasses, please, in a rather emotional, to the beautiful bride. I think just kind of one last thank you as well, and again, I'm speaking on behalf of Petra here. It has to go to the bridesmaids and groomsmen, but not necessarily just bridesmaids and groomsmen, to actually all our friends, because just all does so well in helping out, you know, the whole thing. I know Petra's bridesmaids just the past year have done a great job of giving her advice as to what she wants to do. Guys, the past few days, you've been absolutely fantastic in just helping out and wanting to get involved, and it's made our day even more special. And also, of course, the organisation with the Stag of Hendu. I'll safely say we'll not be doing any triple gins today, and I will not be getting naked in front of everyone like Stag, but hopefully the debauchery which occurred on Stag won't be occurring today. So ladies and gentlemen, if you'd please raise your glasses and final toast to the bridesmaids and groomsmen.
Okay, so firstly, on behalf of everyone here, I'd like to thank Petra and Ben for choosing to hold a reception in a brewery. So, an inspired decision. Also glad that Ben was particularly dashing this time, because more can be said for his outfit of choice at the last brewery he visited. I'd also like to thank my sister, the maid of honour, for a fantastic speech. And for also taking all the Romeo and Juliet references. I'm absolutely screwed now. Ben has admitted to me on a number of occasions he's not actually that particularly worried about the speech, and truth be told, he's right. After a lot of hard thinking, it quickly became clear that Ben is Teflon. Nothing will stick to him at all. One of Ben's great passions in life has always been cars. His first car that he owned was a Peugeot 106, and being one of the first guys in the year at St. Peter's School to own a car, he finally started to gain friends. In order to ensure he remained a reliable taxi service or friend, we called him Handbrake Hansen in order to flatter his ego as the next Michael Schumacher. Unfortunately, his ego and nickname got the best of him at times. After a party, Ben courageously agreed to be the designated friend so that no one else could drink alcohol. Leaving the party, particularly worse for wear, Ben heeded the calls for handbrake, 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 and pulled a series of handbrake turns in the Weatherby Men's Working Club, until that Lewis Hamilton was discovered in similar circumstances. Ben realising that he was most likely the next Michael Schumacher, took those driving skills and promptly crashed into the back of a lady at a roundabout, completely writing off his first car. When asked how his impeccable driving skills had avoided the crash, he responded, "Some bloody woman stopped in front of me at a roundabout, stupid hell." I know it's difficult to imagine that this Milky Bar kid lookalike was capable of such a vulgarity. Ben took his passion for cars and got his first break into employment when he took a position with Formula One Honda, a team who had been involved in Formula One since way back in 1964. Mysteriously, months after Ben's arrival, Formula One Honda went out of business. Now, it could simply be coincidence or the poor economy, but clearly given Ben's poor grasp of the highway code, I can't help but wonder. Ben's second passion in life is a common one that we can all relate to: rucksacks. Yes, ever since I've known his people lookalike, he's always had the latest in rucksack technology. If he's planning on staying at mine in the New York City Centre, he would come prepared with an Arctic rucksack with which to carry books, clothes, survival gear for a night out in York, I might add, and all manner of hiking equipment. Ben could pack everything except for his self-respect into one of those rucksacks. Ben was a model scout and always prepared. Before heading out for a night in the town, he was set at the base camp. He was set with a roll mat, sleeping bag, hiking water bottle, what I can only assume was alpine water. Come in the morning, I would be feeling horrendous, with kebabs surrounding my bed, whilst part Donny Osmond, part Bear Grylls, would be fresh-faced sipping in glacier water and probably carving chorizo sausage with his Swiss Army knife.
I think I know that.
They're obsessed with me even today. In fact, Petra is now becoming dazed by their presence. Just over a year ago, Ben informed Petra that they were going to the local pub. Naturally, Ben put on his rucksack. Petra didn't really question why. If it was anyone else, alarm bells would have been ringing right there. But this time, Ben replaced his camp stove for a bottle of champagne, and en route to the pub, he took Petra's hand and asked her to marry him. I would like to add that it was quite presumptuous that Petra's going to say yes by taking the champagne with you, Ben. But if Ben was always carrying ice axes, rope and tinder to make fires, and then made by myself in quite a precarious position, skiing off peace in France, I took a nasty tumble and badly injured my knee. At that time, I was thankful to have this fresh-faced Prince of Charles and Nelly Sport skiing with me. One dig into his mighty rucksack, and I had all the equipment I needed to survive an avalanche in the Himalayas. Or a night out in a terrace house in the centre of York, and apparently game was interchangeable. I also recall spending many hours with Ben at school, skipping school lunches in favour of a deli sandwich from down the road. Ben would flirt outrageously with a six-year-old woman, creatively nicknamed Salami Woman, behind the cold meat counter, and in return, he would get extra meat. Unfortunately for all concerned, that's not a euphemism. Ben was also greatly offended by school lunches, more so than I, and I've worked out that during his time at St. Peter's, he spent £5,500 on his own school lunches. That's a hefty sum of money, so don't get upset, Ben, but with that money, you could have bought 3,666 metres of climbing rope, 62 high-quality rucksacks, or according to Oxfam, you could have saved 32,352 people from dying in Mozambique. Which is more than the population of Monaco, so think about that the next time you head to a Grand Prix. We now need to be able to save quite a few lives in order to save right bench wrongs. You may also wonder how Ben has changed since he has met Petra. On the last night out in York, a number of us were checking out a group of attractive ladies. In a big burst of energy, Ben leapt into action and promptly picked up a handful of leaves from the road, exclaiming, "Petra will love these already, passing on project." To this day, I'll make sure that any nights out, avoid a local bar in case Ben decides to embark on a spot of flower arranging. Somehow the phrase "get your geraniums out for the last" just doesn't quite work. As the best man and officer, I'm expected to offer a few words of advice before you embark on your journey with backpack no doubt. As a married man, now most of the instructors understand the correct meaning of what their other half is saying, but Ben suffers a further disadvantage that he must first translate it from the Czech. I therefore offer a few lines that you should watch out for. Now before I do this, I'd like to forewarn all of you that I'm going to attempt and check, so I'll apologise if I actually end up offending someone's grandmother. Not going to go well, but okay. I thought Ben's with birth, but okay. I say, Ano, Sheko, Jivu, Prashku, which is nothing what it sounds like, I'm sure, but it's meant to be, yes, everything is fine. Which Ben should simply translate to meaning, no, everything is not fine, how could you not know that? The second sentence you look out for is, Jamie, Jendo, Kam, Pujme, which is, I don't care, let's go wherever, which of course actually means, You better know where you're taking me, and I better bloody like it. And finally, a common one we should all look out for is Musime si promnovit. Yeah, it's obvious, isn't it? It's we need to talk. Which actually means I need to complain about you. But Ben is kind, he's loyal, honest, and the most genuine guy I know. I would like to add similar compliments from those friends who attended as I do. However, most of the comments I can't read out, and the nicest one simply a like due to Jimmy Savile. I'd like at this stage to also read out a few quotes from those friends who couldn't come to your wedding and drink your free alcohol. James Rolden said, where was my invite? I never liked you anyway. Alex Bell said, I'm thrilled to be celebrating a special day here in York. Petra said no invite. No invite. Clearly our night in Vietnam meant nothing to you. I've also known Petra for many years too. Living briefly in Bristol, it would be impossible to walk down the street or sit in the bar where Petra didn't know a passerby or the chef. She's the kindest, most friendliest person I know. She's also the only person I know to openly discuss the pros and cons of euthanasia on a drinking holiday. Or indeed play drinking games on the same holiday with mugs of tea. I also implore all of you to ask Petra about the Czech Easter Bank Holiday tradition, from what I understand simply involves women being spanked and then handing a guy as a gift in return. Of course, this is usually lost in translation, but it's nonetheless what makes Petra unique. I will also say now, Michael, that I have always thought it rude not to submerge yourself into another's culture, and I am willing to get involved in this tradition next Monday. But I thought I'd end on a nicer note. It was in France during a holiday, as you've heard a few times already this evening, with a big group of mine and my sister's friends that Ben and Petra first met. Ben was sleeping on the floor in my room, and on the first night, after only knowing Petra briefly, being introduced to her briefly, he turned to me and said, "Sam, do you know that Petra girl? She's the most beautiful and most perfect girl that has anything I could possibly want." And from that moment, ladies and gentlemen, this evening was never in doubt. Ben, I have and will always consider you to be a close friend, and I'm truly honoured that you asked me to be your best man. The location for the wedding was fantastic, the ceremony beautiful, the reception amazing, the bridesmaids, all of whom look stunning, and I'm sure I speak for all of everyone here when I say we have the most perfectly matched bride and groom sat with us today. On behalf of everyone, I wish you all the happiness, and so I'd like to raise a glass for the final time without a glass. To the bride and groom, Mr. and Mrs. Hansen.
Yeah. tell all the boys no makes you feel good, yeah. I know you're out of my league, but that won't scare me away, oh no. You've carried on so long, you couldn't stop if you tried it. You've built your wall so high that no one could climb it. But I'm gonna try, would you let me see beneath your beautiful, would you let me see beneath your puppet? Take it off now, girl, take it off now, girl. I wanna see inside. Would you let me see beneath your beautiful tonight?
Beautiful tonight.